we want to solve the given quadratic equations using square roots. Since we want to use square roots, we do not want to multiply this out, set it equal to 0, and try to factor it. Since the left side of this equation is a perfect square, since we have the quantity 3x minus 5 squared, we can undo the squaring by square rooting both sides of the equation. So we'll leave this as the quantity 3x minus 5 squared equals 4, and then we're going to square root both sides of the equation. So the square root of the left side must equal plus or minus the square root of 4. Well, looking at the left side of this equation, since we have two equal factors underneath the square root, this is a perfect square, so it's going to simplify to just one factor of 3x minus 5. And on the right side, since the square root of 4 is equal to 2, we have plus or minus 2. And now we can just solve this for x to determine our two solutions. So for the next step, we'll add 5 to both sides of the equation. Minus 5 plus 5 is 0, that's why we did that. So now we have 3x equals, on the right side we have 5 plus or minus 2. Leave this in its current form for right now. The last step here is to divide both sides by 3. So this gives us x equals 5 plus or minus 2 divided by 3. Now we don't want to leave it in this form, we actually want to determine the two solutions. So one solution is x equals 5 plus 2 divided by 3, and the other solution is x equals 5 minus 2 divided by 3. Let's go ahead and simplify these. So here we have 5 plus 2 is 7, so we have 7/3, or x equals over here, 5 minus 2 is 3, 3 divided by 3 is equal to 1. So our two solutions are x equals 7/3 or x equals positive 1. We're going to use the same technique in our second example. For our second example, we'll apply the same technique. Again, notice how the left side of the equation, which contains the variable x, is a perfect square. So we can undo the squaring by square rooting both sides of the equation. So we have the quantity x plus 3 squared equals 72. So now we'll square root both sides. Remember, we have a plus or minus here to obtain our two solutions. The quantity x plus 3 squared is a perfect square, so the left side simplifies to one factor of x plus 3. On the right side, we have plus or minus the square root of 72. Notice 72 is not a perfect square, but it does contain perfect square factors. Since 72 is equal to 36 times 2, and the square root of 36 would be 6, this simplifies to the quantity x plus 3 equals plus or minus 6 square root 2. If I lost you there, remember the square root of 72 can be written as the square root of 36 times 2, and again, the square root of 36 is 6, and the 2 stays underneath the square root. So that's where this came from. And for the last step, we just need to subtract 3 from both sides of the equation. This would be 0. So we have x equals, I need to be careful here because these are not like terms. This contains a radical and this doesn't. So our solution is just negative 3 plus or minus 6 square root 2. If we wanted to list the two solutions, we would have x equals negative 3 plus 6 square root 2, or x equals negative 3 minus 6 square root 2. These do not simplify any further. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.